Okay, so we're back now, except we have a new problem on our hands. For whatever reason, Pokemon is running super slowly too. Okay. It's fine. It was not this bad earlier today. Or not earlier today, but yesterday. Anyways, yesterday we caught a whole bunch of legendary Pokemon, like a whole bunch of them. And today we are doing more of that. In lieu of the other stream I had planned for today, which unfortunately I had to cancel because it just was not working smoothly. I need a new setup, is the lesson that I'm learning as we go on here. I'm not skipping frames. Did I seriously skip this trainer? I must have. Oh well. That's fine, it's just Sitaros. I'm faster than you, so confuse Ray. You're gonna be flipping coins, my friend. Got the poison. Snapped out of confusion. Okay, you negated your own intimidate. I mean, yeah, I'm confused, but you're poisoned. I also have full heals, so take that. That's gonna hurt a little bit. There goes. Mm-hmm. Real quick, I need to check something. Okay. Yeah, we're not gonna bother. I don't have repel up. I need to do that. Again, with the double epic dodge. Unfortunately, there aren't that many more legends for us to hunt, so... This may very well be the last Pokémon Platinum stream. Because we've already caught Arceus, we already have the items we need for Dialga and Palkia. We've caught Rotom, we've caught Giratina, we've caught all the Lake Trio, we've caught Cresselia, we've caught Darkrai, we've caught the Legendary Birds. I think there's only two Pokemon that I can think of that we haven't caught yet. Well. I guess technically three. There he is. Let's go ahead and save. Adrian. I'm feeling lucky. Let's go with a quick ball, first turn. Hey! Let's go. The Lava Dome Pokemon. Yep. Salamander. All right, so we've got Heatran. Got Heatran. Got Regigigas. We're only missing two spots in the Synodex, and I can actually get one of them that you guys are unable to. The only one we'll be missing is Pokemon 189, 489, my bad. Not 189, 489. And unfortunately, I don't really have a good way of doing that. I do have a way, but it's not good. Whatever. think I had the wrong Pokemon League, but that's fine. I don't know if it's faster to go in from one side or another. I think it would actually be faster to go in from the other side. Fun fact, you don't actually need waterfall to ride down waterfalls. There was a person there who was blocking our way into that cave, but now they aren't. So all we have to do is somehow get up there, which would be down this rock climb wall, over here, and up. I did fight you already. Also, I didn't pick up this item back when I was in here earlier. A zinc. How exciting. In this part of Victory Road. We need defog. Forget Confuse Ray. I can reteach that. I can reteach Confuse Ray, so that won't be a problem. Hooray, we did it. Unfortunately, we cannot surf while we have a companion with us. So we have to go the long way around. Let's do the double battle thing. Get the flinch, that would be great. Not that it matters, actually. That's gonna hurt a little bit. Oh boy, that thing just got dangerous. Wasn't enough. Goodbye. Have fun, Arcanine. Yeesh. Why would you use two extreme speeds and not one more Fire Fang? Seriously. No, I missed. Well, bye, Arcanine. Please tell me you have more than just Arcanine. Nope, not dealing with this. It's just a one-on-one. And you missed. Flinch. Nope. There's the Stone Edge. I might survive, but probably not. Oh, I did. Somehow I survived. What would Endeavor do for you? I'll tell you what it would do. Nothing. Sensei Girl 63. And about to send in Kangaskhan. Well, I'm about to not have Sunstead out. Bye. And that's that. Oh, so much money. Oh wait, hang on, I can go around it. Nailed it. so this... I actually have a story about this cave area. On my first playthrough of Pokemon Pearl, I got in here, and I was messing around with my action. I was messing around with an action replay because I wasn't good at video games till I decided to get good. And I was walking on water with Marley following me, and I got into an aquatic double battle, which, since that's not supposed to happen, I only encountered one real Pokemon, and essentially missing No, even though it was not missing No. So if you somehow found a way to walk through walls, to run on the surface of water with a partner following you, then you could, in theory, legitimately catch and encounter glitch Pokemon. Granted, if you can get a setup without cheating that allows you to walk on water, you could probably just encounter glitch Pokemon. Like, without even going through the setup trouble. Low enough HP that I figured it would attack it with extreme speed. Well, that's gonna hurt. Was this team just designed to take down Crobats? Why? Arcanine, you're not helping, and I'm gonna faint. No, not quite. Should use the cross poison on you. Bother with getting those items. Even though they are probably good, I just want to get out of here. Okay, I'm going to target Mankey. You have a quad weak target and Fire Fang. Never mind. It ended up being a good play anyway. Getting rid of that Infernape before it can do anything. Sunset, you're level 64. Thank you! You finally did something good, Arcanine. Okay, this is just a bad matchup. Oh. Hey, you have Helping Hand! Awesome. If I had coaxed you into doing that again... Assuming you survived this... You did not. Does it carry over? I don't know if Fly carries over or not. Maybe it does? I don't know. Didn't matter. Ha, you missed. And now I leave. Slimer. Congratulations. Surf's up! Really? Fine, whatever. Slimer grew level 62. Well done. Formatting on that was real weird. Leading in this fight. She-Hulk. She-Hulk hasn't seen nearly enough action. Alright, well, let's get some setup going. I basically have a Shirley Rose. Special defense Shrubbly Rose. Arcanine, are you seriously not going to just extreme speed that Dratini? You deserve an outrage for the face. Oh man, what does Helping Hand do to acupressure? Does it raise it by 3 stages? No, it probably does nothing. Oh. Well, that's rude. I got rid of all my defense changes. How dare you? There we go. This ought to help a little bit. That's what you get for taking my buffs. And now it's confused. And Arcanine took the feature set attack, so it's probably... Oh no, it's not quite gone yet. Let's throw down some toxic spikes. More toxic spikes. And you're gonna hurt yourself in confusion. In comes the crunch. And you're badly poisoned. Which means unless you've got a full restore, this entire battle's on a timer. I'm gonna reduce that timer though. Digging won't let you escape. And I'm faster, so if I can get a defense up. Special attack. Well, this is gonna hurt quite a bit. But it's fine. Goodbye. She-Hulk is very capable. Man, Dragon Tamer almost found it. Have to do the strength puzzle down there. I am really not afraid in this fight. Yeah, I'm terribly intimidated. In fact, I'm so intimidated that I'm gonna throw down toxic spikes. Just two of them, though. Why do you people keep hitting me with electric-type attacks? I mean, yeah, I could take it down, but I'm trying to do some setup here. Acupressure. And just going to do this till Arcanine faints, to be honest. Speed sharply rose. No, I can keep going for a little bit. Accuracy sharply rose. Okay, yeah, you're just going to be a pain, so... Speed and accuracy are all I really need. Oh, are you serious? Oh, good, because it's levitating, it doesn't get rid of the toxic spikes. Thank goodness. Unfortunately, that means that the toxic spikes that I set up were actually useless. It's fine, though. Because I swept. Because that's what She-Hulk does. No. This looks like it's just a regular old maze. Just a regular ear of corn. It's not even that. Well, it probably is, but it isn't right now. That's what matters. So I guess while we're here, finishing this up, how about them Pokemon Let's Go games that are not leaks anymore, or rumors. They are in fact real. It's interesting. I really dig the art style. Like, if there's one thing to take away from that, it's that Generation 8 is going to look fantastic when it comes out. This isn't... This... Like, these games may be core RPGs, but they're not main series core RPGs. They are core RPGs in that they use the battle formula and the type effectiveness from the main series games. They also take place in the main series games. Namely, Yellow. I'm doing this now. Fine. Who can come out here? Slimer can. I guess we're only setting up one toxic spikes, which is fine. Hi! You protected this turn, but you weren't the target. So yeah, the art style and like the visual presentation of Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee are freaking phenomenal. Like, there's a lot of visual fidelity there, and if that's what Game Freak has cooking for Gen 8, like, if that's the tech we're looking at, then these games are going to look fantastic. And I'm super excited about that. as for the Pokemon Go stuff, I mean, it seems to be going over well, at least. I've seen a couple people complain, like, yeah, it is Go, but... But two-player simultaneous co-op. That's my response to that. Ooh, this might be enough to take out Machamp. Stormbrain took the attack! Ha ha, you fool! I wish it recovered HP. I wish it, like, boosted my special attack, but... Oh well. At least I saved Arcanine. Whoa, why is my bitrate fluctuating so much? This AI really wants that Arcanine gone. Please be going for something that isn't Fire Fang. And that preferably isn't Agility. You know, Arcanine, you could hit this thing too. It's not just up to me to hit this thing. You have extreme speed. It's not a ghost type, it's a flying type. It's water flying. You can hit this thing with extreme speed. There is no reason for this. No! Why can't... It is within KO range if you just use extreme speed. Is it because your attack is lowered? Is that your logic? It has to be that. There's no reason. Its HP is so low, it would not go in for the KO. It wouldn't not go in for the KO. If it, like, if the attack wasn't lowered, I guess. Welcome to Route 224. This place is pretty tough. And there's a third upgrade if you've got more Porygons you want to evolve. Thank you. This could take a while. Defense triply rose. I can set up all I like against this thing though. Special defense triply rose. And it's obvious this thing thinks exactly the same as I do. Except here's your problem, dude. You've got three Pokemon. And I'm only intending on using one. Unless push comes to shove. See, that's all the setup you have is the problem. Meanwhile, I'm still setting up. Oh yeah, no, I've got nothing to worry about from this thing. Nope, failed. We're already as set up as possible. This muck might not fall that easily, but it's fine. Mainly because of all those defense ups from Acid Armor. The rest of his team won't be any problem. Yeah, I'm about to send in Lickitung. I'm about to use Cross Poison, and there's nothing you can do about it. Oh no, you lowered my attack by one stage. Critical hit. Ultra Ball. Oh, jeez. Do you guys think I can make that? I'm gonna say yes. And since I have Oak's letter, I don't think it matters what you put here, as long as you write something. I just chose to thank Shaman because, hey, guess what we're fighting? Are you guys ready to go on to the longest route in the game? This is the longest route in the entire game. There are no encounters here. There's no tall grass, no surfing, no fishing. It's just flowers. This is the thanks you get after your journey. Or, supposedly. That part's conjecture, as the Oak's Letter event was never released. And as your final reward here in Flower Paradise, where it's just a bunch of flowers. It has to save a lot of data because it unlocked this area. Same thing with New Moon Island and Darkrai. Don't fail him now. Shaman! Go, Nest Ball! This is a minimum level for it to work. Hey! First try! Yep, we have to. You know what? Normally I don't do this, but it's far too convenient and I don't have any ideas, so its nickname will just be its name with proper capitalization. And with that, that is every legendary Pokemon. That is every area explored, except for this route here, but who cares? There's nothing there anyway. That is every legendary Pokemon captured. Every gym taken down. Oh wait, hang on. Not yet! Are you crazy? You're not done yet, you don't have Dialga or Palkia. Those are all the event ones though. So there is only one more thing to do. And that last thing we have to do is buy some more of these. I think we're okay on Pokeballs. These last few encounters haven't exactly been taxing on that front. I need to put up a repel. This is a big deal. This is probably going to be the last part of Pokemon Platinum. Because I can't think of much else there is to do once we catch Dialga and Palkia. I mean, there is something we can do, but unfortunately, there just isn't a whole lot left here. So I guess this will be the finale to Everyday May. Tomorrow will be the Battle Frontier Spectacular. Because I can't really think of anything else, so yeah, tomorrow will be the Battle Frontier Spectacular. Why are they not here, though? Is it because I did the Arceus event? Like, they won't spawn if I did the Arceus event? Do I have to have Giratina in my party? Hang on, I gotta look this up. Oh, okay, hang on, I'm missing a step. We're gonna need to make the Mount Coronet track one more time, which is good, because I need to fill time. We need to fly over to Celestic Town. Now that we have the orbs, we need to head in and investigate the cave painting. Tell Spectre War off. There we go. Now we should be able to head up to Spear Pillar. That book there is actually different in both Diamond and Pearl. Welcome back, Chase. Yeah, in Diamond and Pearl, that book will show you the Pokedex entry for the other Fox Legendary. So, for instance, in Pokemon Pearl, it would show you Dialga's entry, and in Diamond, it would show you Palkia's. Yo! Chase, thanks for the host. Unfortunately, I had to switch over from Fortnite because it was just being way too problematic. My computer is not powerful enough to stream Fortnite. And, not gonna lie, I would have kept going, regardless, except I wasn't having fun either. I totally get the appeal of Fortnite, but it's just not for me. So, we're here just finishing up catching legendaries in Pokemon Platinum instead. Sounds fun. So, I have learned a few things from this project. Namely, I learned how to inject DS games onto Wii U Virtual Console, so that opens up a lot of doors. Especially for some of the shovelware I played as a kid. Bakugan DS game, anyone? Came with the colorless Naga? I saw it at a GameStop for like $2 regular price. 99 cents pro price. I don't know, I might want to try that. If the ROM exists, is the thing. How would that be for a follow-up game? Go from Pokemon Platinum, arguably a fan favorite in the series, to go to a piece of shovelware like Bakugan Battle Brawlers for the DS. That sounds like something I'd do, to be honest. Has to save a lot of data again because we unlocked the encounters with Dialga and Palkia. RIP. We're not even an hour and a half into this platinum stream. Which means we've only been going for 2.5 hours total today. Okay, these things are level 70. This probably won't work. But man, would it be funny! Okay, hang on a second. Hold up. We're gonna fight Palkia, and then I need to double check something again. Because that should not have happened. Yep. Oh. Perfect. Unfortunately, we have to refresh the map. Alright, I'm gonna challenge Pelky, then double check something real quick. Because that should not have worked. There's something I can do to check. If I throw this heal ball and it catches, then something's up. Okay. Let me just... Give me a minute. Oh. So for those who weren't here last time, I was trying to catch Regigigas. I was trying to catch Regigigas, the level 1 Pokemon, and I was also trying to catch roaming legendaries. So I used an action replay code because I really didn't care. Guess what I forgot to do? I'm sorry. I really am. If I had remembered to turn this off, if I had remembered to turn the code off, then I totally would have, because it would have filled up 3 hours nicely, but here we are. Let me just turn that off here. Save and... Alright. I mean, it's a little too late now, but I had to make sure. Yep. Just space. Insert clip of Tim Curry here. Alright, and with that, we're done here. That spot there is occupied by Fione, and is the only remaining unseen Pokemon in all of Sinnoh. In all the Sinnoh part of the Pokedex, anyway. Anyways. Let's fly off to the fight area, I guess. And as we still have an hour and a half to go, I guess we're changing games again. That's fine, we can change games again. So, who's up for more glitchy fun in PokéGlitch? I'm curious to see what else we can do. Unfortunately, we're going to go on another break, so again, get up, stretch, grab a drink, I know I will, or a snack. Do what you gotta do, but don't log off yet, 'cause we'll be right back. Again.